Let us see the summary of the male reproductive system and what is the actual functions of each and every organelle which is arranged in this particular male reproductive system. As I discussed, sebaceous glands and prostate glands. What are these three? These three are the, as I told you, these three are the accessory glands, is it not? These are the accessory glands. And the seminal vesicles are two in number. Corpus glands are two in number. Prostate gland is only one. Very, very important. And the urethra, penis and the scrotum. Now let us see the functions of this particular each and every part of the male reproductive system. Testis, the main function of the testis is it produces the sperms and testosterone, which is very, very important. Okay, next is the epididymis. What is epididymis? The cushion-like structure which is giving comfort for this particular testis. And what is the function of this particular epididymis? It matures and stores the sperms. Maturation and also storage. The maturation and the storage of the sperms occur here. So let us see the functions of each and every part of this male reproductive system. The first one is the testis. The main function of testis is it produces the sperms and testosterone. Okay, the male ego, or I can say, or you can say that the rigidity and all these things which are present in the human males is dependent on this particular hormone which is called as a testosterone. So the main function of the testis is the produces sperms and testosterone. Next part is the epididymis. What is the function of the epididymis? It matures and also stores the sperms. Not only storing the sperms, the process of maturation is also done by the epididymis. Now the third one is the sperm duct. Okay, what is the function of the sperm duct? As we have seen, it carries the sperms from the epididymis to the urethra. From the epididymis to the urethra, I told you in my previous class, no, a small tube like structure is coming. So that is the sperm duct. The function is to carriage, that is transport from one place to the another. From where? From the epididymis to the urethra. Next is the seminal vesicles, corpus glands, prostate glands. What are these three called as the accessory glands? What are the functions? What is the need of this accessory glands? It produces the seminal fluid which feeds the sperms and allows them to swim. Okay, it allows them to swim also. How it is swimming? Is it having any fins like fishes? No. We'll see what is the structure of the sperm and what are the different parts of the sperm and how it is able to move from one place to another. That we call it as the motility. Okay, it will be having a flagellum, a whip like structure, which we call it as the flagellum, right? From that region or with that particular part of that sperm, it will move, for it will swim. Okay, so produces the accessory glands, produces the seminal fluid. What is that? It is the lubricating fluid which is lodging all the sperms in it, and in that particular fluid they all will swim. And the sperms and the seminal fluid are collectively called as the semen. Okay, it is also important. Just that's why I just highlighted that. Next is the urethra. What is the function of urethra? It allows and also the passage of the urine or the sperm, is it not? So as I told you, the main function of the male reproductive system, the urethra, this is that part of the male reproductive system which is helping both in the excretion and also in the reproduction. That is why its function is it will be allowing both the urine and also the sperms. As I told you, this urethra will be present inside the penis. So which is our next part, that it places the sperms inside the body of the female. This is the external genitalia of the male reproductive system in the man. Not only in the man, you can see this part in other mammals also. In other mammals, in the sense, in different types of monkeys and different types of other mammals, highly evolved mammals like cheetahs, dogs, buffaloes, horses. So there the main function is the, it places the sperms inside the body of the female. And the last part, which is not the least, it is the scrotum. It keeps the testis at a lower temperature, as I told you, and it maintains at 35 degrees centigrade or 93 degree Fahrenheit. This is the optimum temperature for the meiosis to occur. What is meant by meiosis? You all know that here the division of the cells will take place and the different daughter cells will be coming out. So the main function of the scrotum is not only maintaining the temperature. In one word, we can say the scrotum is acting like a fridge. Is it not? What will be the temperature inside the fridge? When compared to outside, it is very, very cool. Is it not, when we compare to outside the fridge? So in the same way, you can describe this, or you can compare the scrotum with our fridge. So it maintains the temperature, lower temperature, and also it sees that the cytogenesis also occurs.